Greetings to all the young learners. Welcome to the official YouTube channel of SRN International School. I am Pallavi Tandon, Faculty of English at SRN International School, situated in Jagatpura, Jaipur. Today we will be learning about the poem from grade 10th from English Language and Literature titled The Ball Poem, written by John Berryman. Now let us know the central idea of the poem. The poet John Berryman in the ball poem describes the grief of a boy over the loss of his ball. With that loss, he senses his first responsibility in the materialistic world, where those whom you love and your worldly possessions will not be with you. The poem shows how all through your life you will be forced to do things that you don't want to do, and you will lose or have to give up the things that you love. But despite this, you have to learn to stand up, to be strong and get on with your life, no matter how much it hurts inside, because that is the only way you will survive. It thus teaches us to learn to accept and let go and not cling on to something that you can never have. Now, children, let me tell you the summary of the poem. The Ball Poem, it's written by poet John Berryman, as I told you, and it is beautifully in this poem been described a boy who has lost his ball. He gave a lesson that is full of wisdom through the loss of everyone. Everyone, the poet says that it is all about a little boy. For the first time in his young life, he is learning what it is like to experience grief at the loss of a much loved possession. That is his ball. The ball is here symbolic of the sweet memories of his childhood. The boy loses his ball and watches it bouncing down the street into the water. To us, the loss of a ball is of minor consequence, but to the little boy, it was a valued possession. The poet here deters himself from saying that there are other balls because the boy wants the same ball. The ball had been with him for a long time, and it was linked to the memories of the days when he played with it. Now, moving to stanza 2, and it says, an ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. I would not intrude on him. A dime, another ball is worthless. So, here it means when the young boy loses his ball, it bounces away and lands in the harbor. The boy is very much troubled at the loss of his ball and plunges into grief. He stands stiff and trembling while staring at his ball. He is upset and he looks into the gloomy water because he cannot find the ball. The boy is profoundly affected by the loss of his ball because it has been with him for a long time. When the ball bounces into the water, all his memories of the childhood days flashes in front of him. This leads to a realization that those moments would not come back, just like the ball. Moreover, the poet says that it does not want to intervene the boy's thoughts, as through this experience, the boy will learn the meaning of loss on his own. Further, the poet doesn't offer him money to buy another ball, because that would be worthless. Now he senses first responsibility in a world of possessions. People will take balls. Balls will be lost always. Little boy, and no one buys a ball back. Money is external. Here in this stanza, we see that the boy is upset when he looks into the gloomy water, because he cannot find the ball. This is when he gets his first sense of responsibility. The poet suggests that from the loss of the ball, the boy is learning what it means to lose something in a world of possessions, where he will lose things, will buy some more to replace the ones lost, but would never be able to buy back the thing that he had lost. In this poem, the boy's ball personifies his young days and happy innocence. In this world, people will take balls just as they will take away your innocence and force you to grow up. And once you lose this innocence, you can never get it back. Balls will be lost always, and no one buys a ball back. The poet thus makes the boy understand about his responsibility, as the loss is immaterial. Money is external, as it cannot buy memories, nor can it replace the things that we love, the things that really matter. Now in stanza 4, we see he is learning, well behind his desperate eyes, the epistemology of loss, how to stand up, knowing what every man must one day know, and most know many days, how to stand up. In these lines, the poet suggests that from the loss of the ball, the boy is learning how to stand up in a world of possessions. The boy is learning what it means to lose something. The poet says that knowing that every man has to stand up after such losses, the boy too will learn how to stand up and leave the losses behind, as he would have to understood the true meaning and the nature of loss. Now, let us have a look on the poetic device. In this particular poem, the ball poem, it includes the poetic devices like anaphora, imagery. First of these is anaphora, where it's a kind of repetition that is focused on the first lines of the poem. For example, merrily, at the start of the line 3 and 4, and at the start of lines 18 and 19. Now, first of all, let me tell you that it is written in blank verse. It's unrhymed and written in iambic pentameter. You can see, what is the boy now who has lost his ball? Merrily bouncing down the street, and then merrily over there, it is in the water. Next, we have symbolism. The ball symbolizes the boy's young and innocent days. Then we have repetition. You must have noticed here, what, balls. This reflects repetition. Then we have alliteration, what, or balls, halls, buys a hall hack. I hope you have understood the poem well, along with the theme and the poetic device. If you have found this video to be helpful, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.